Hello Biscuits, welcome back to another video. As I'm filming this, it's actually International Lolita Day, so happy ILD to all of you. I hope you've done something to celebrate. Doesn't matter, big or small, I hope you celebrated somehow. I'm actually straight back from a meet, so excuse poor lighting. Even though it's summer and there's still some natural light coming in, not quite enough. But I wanted to capitalise on already being in full Lolita and do an unboxing! There's quite a few Japanese auction bits. Not all of the ones in here are Lolita. There's some magazines, some more casual things. But we'll go through all of that. Let's just call it Japanese auction haul. So now what we need to do is get from this to this. Oh gosh, it's all stuck to the bottom, so bear with. Let's go through things. Sorry for the shocked expression, but there's a tag. I do not remember buying this as new with tag. Oh no, I think it's just included. This is a dress by Metamorphose Tone de Fil. And it's polka dot sharing pinafore, which, ta-da! Now waist ties, there it is. There's a bow that goes at the waist or wherever you want it to go. And something that looks kind of like a petticoat but without poof. Underskirt, I do remember it being mentioned. As you saw from the tag there, when it was new it costed just under 20,000 yen. I got this for 2,300 yen, which I believe was about £15 at the time. And what I'm so chuffed with and positively surprised by is none of the stock photos and none of the sellers' photos showed that, but this dress has sparkly bits on it. I'll do my best. Can you see? Ah! Oh my gosh. I'm so looking forward to wearing this casually, not casually. This dress is fully lined. There are still some spare buttons for either the waist ties or all the straps, excuse me. And for such an impulse buy, I'm actually really loving it. It's incredible. I think I'll get lots of wear out of this. It's made out of polyester and it feels kind of, well, it feels like chiffon-y polyester, so it should be fabulous for summer as well. Oh. Again, I did not expect to love this dress as much as I did. I feel like I've set the tone and the bar so high for this unboxing that let's hope the other bits aren't disappointing. Very, very, very chuffed. Oh my gosh, it's sparkling! It's a sparkly dress for £15. Pure Brando. Let's pick something less Brando. What I have here is the Kotso from Axis Fan in camera's absolutely rubbish, and the lighting. It's a dark green. There's the vaguest kind of emerald, because it's more satiny. The rest of it feels more like forest green. What I didn't realise is the buttons on the bib are fully functional, they're not just decoration. There's a detachable bow, let's get it out of there. It's a little bow pin to go on your collar. And even though it's not technically Brando, I was hoping to wear it with Brando. I'm hoping to extend my Lolita wardrobe by adding some green things. Gradually, so starting off with this cutso, because let me tell you, finding blouses in dark green, very difficult. So I'm very glad to have found this. I hope it'll fit, I hope it won't look weird on people with boobs. There's a decent amount of stretch, so should be fine. And yeah, I'm looking forward to expanding my wardrobe with another jewel top. Sorry, I had the moment of what on earth could I buy? But also from Axis Fan, although I'm not sure if there's a way to confirm that. Kind of jumping on that LARM hype, and I bought a pair of fluffy pom pom earrings. And the best part about them, the pom-pom bit's actually detachable. Yeah. So you can wear just the bow, or you can wear it with a pom-pom. Ooh, the pom-pom's very soft and fluffy. And yeah, I think that would be cute, but around the size I imagine they'd be. It might be a bit too warm to wear fluffy pom-poms right now, but we'll give them a go. Something in a Disney bag. Then I got a pair of AP socks on auction with some gold crowns. I believe it's called crown rosettes. Rosette crown? Lovely. Oh, I honestly can't remember. What I'm slightly disappointed with is I thought the bows and these bits inside the rosettes, that they were navy. That's how they looked on the auction photo, but they're actually black. However, because they're such a minor detail and they'll only be on one side of the leg, I think this is something that we can live with. Could just about potentially be more under the knees rather than over the knees, but look at that stretch. So yeah, I'm hoping that adding some regal bits eventually, maybe to wear with that one popular AP crown release that I can't seem to get my hands on, but let's not mention that for now. Let's not ruin our moods. I think I'll get plenty of use out of the socks, even though I don't wear black things, because it is quite a minor detail on an otherwise very lovely pair of socks. I think I'll be able to work it into a cord. Let's save this for last, so that we start the unboxing on a hype and end it on a hype. Then I took advantage and bought the last paper edition of Kera. Sad times to see Kera not be printed anymore. But as we already have Kera online, it started going, it's moved digital, and I think it's gone in the right direction. But yeah, last ever issue of Kera. And then I got what I believe is now quite an old issue of Eternita, however you want to pronounce this. So I believe this is aimed at more otona kawaii and otomeke, and there's some Lolita bits in there. So this I've bought mainly to see if it's a publication worth following, have a browse through, but also maybe get some inspiration for my daily wardrobe, which seems to be expanding in the otomeke direction. And especially for me, I know this is a minor point for most of you out there, but since graduating from university, when I was doing Japanese studies, I have lost quite a lot of contact with the language, so any kind of publication like this means I'm still staying in touch with Japanese language, and I'm able to pick up more natural, maybe a bit more natural things, maybe a bit of current slang you speak, whatever it is. So still great. Last but not least, here's the thing that started this whole order, which is a little something from Closet Child. Can you guess what the print is yet? If any of you know me, you'll know that I've been quite on the lookout for this print. But I didn't want to go over a certain price. I didn't think it was worth more than a certain price. So when it popped up on Closet Child, for a price I was happy to pay, and as a set with head bow, I just jumped on it. This is the head bow. Is it wired? Yes, it's wired. So you can fluff it up. Look how different that looks from this. Can you guess what the print is? Ta-da! This is Baby the Stars Shine Brights, I believe 2015 Lucky Pack print called Secret Airmail from Sweet Kitty. I have no idea how I missed it being there when it was released in 2015. I was either trying to ignore it because, gosh, I'm too poor, but more like I just completely missed it until I saw another YouTuber unbox it and show the details. I was like, this is actually such a cute print. So the speech is quite simple bodice, but the print is this amazing array of stuffed toys. There it is, there's the kitten. Lots of letters. Some rose pink ink, I believe. Some birds. It's a very, very cute print. The material on the dress is actually quite thick as well. Yes, so the dress is 100% cotton. Features removable waist ties but not adjustable straps. There's some front corset lacing and a detachable at the front. Detachable bow at the front. And no zips, but full back sharing, as tends to be quite common with Lucky Pack prints. So yeah, I'm very happy to have nabbed this set at the price that I did. I really look forward to wearing it. This is something that's been on my wish list for quite a while, but I was only after this particular colourway, not the red and pink, but the red and blue. There's so much I could do with this. I'm absolutely loving print, and I'm glad that I nabbed it. And as usual with Closet Child, you pretty much get it in perfect condition. And because of how thick the cotton is, I'll probably be able to wear it in winter as well, which is, you'd expect it, and was a happy pack released in winter, but it's not always that obvious or that common. So very happy with this. And this concludes my Japanese auction haul. I hope you've enjoyed unboxing things with me and going through the different surprises. I'm still so chuffed about that Meta dress being sparkly. It's unbelievable. I might literally just put it on tomorrow just so I can wear it and be sparkly. But yes, I hope you've enjoyed this. As usual, I'd love for you to comment, like, or subscribe to the channel. It's great to be interacting with you. I haven't checked for a while, but I believe we're almost at 100 subscribers. It's weird, given that I started this channel purely for the unboxing. It's incredible. I'd never thought I'd get even that far. Sorry, I only just noticed that and it bothered me. And as usual, I encourage all of you to check out my blog, Cupcakes and Unicorns, where you'll find more details and more related stuff. You'll find a full rundown and an outfit shot of this thing, rather than just seeing here up. And a little post about how I've spent my ILD with the Yorkshire Com. And until next time, take care. Bye!